Please welcome Dana Trattner.
Hi, my name is Dana, and I'm an artist from Cape Elizabeth. My media is chalk pastel, and what you're seeing is my most recent work, which has changed and evolved just like it does for every artist. Except the exception is that I've had various eye conditions and treatments, and as my eyes have gone through sudden changes, so has my art. I was born with keratoconus, or conical corneas. I'm nearsighted and has astigmatism. I'm also actually colorblind. In elementary school, I was probably the only student who almost failed the colorblind test. I can remember the frustration of the school nurse as she told me to look harder at the little dots to find a number. Finally, she actually gave me a hint so I could pass. Treatment for keratoconus is corneal transplants, which I had two of when I was in my 30s. Now, my vision was normal at the time with contact lenses, but I was just having problems with the lenses, with wearing them. This was done before my first transplant in the hospital in New York. This distorted perspective is not intentional. It happens to be my style, and it's indicative of my work before my transplant. I just drew. It was just the way I drew. Now, this was done right before the second transplant, and as you can see, it's totally different. With my new cornea, the signal changed from my eye to my hand, and gone was my style. Since then, my work kind of lacks the distortions unique that, from prior to that. But one thing that I didn't miss was the very bland visual world that I think I saw. I was told my work was always too flat, and there wasn't enough contrast with what I was what I mostly heard. Yet leaving the hospital, I remember being amazed by the intense contrast and colors that I first saw. So started a series of people on the Casco Bay ferries, as we had a summer cottage at the time. And this is a giclée print that I made of my original pastel. I also started a series of sun goddesses and sun gods on the beaches. This was also another giclée print. I felt that I wanted to capture the intense colors and contrast that I suddenly saw, and became frustrated with the pastels because in trying to get that intensity, I often would overwork a piece. So I ended up starting to scan my originals and use Photoshop to intensify the saturation of the colors. My final product ended up being the prints, and I sold a lot of them. Occasionally, I'd run into someone who really wanted to buy an original, and they were usually disappointed that my originals, such as this, is not quite as vibrant as my prints. I finally agreed and started using what I learned from my Photoshop saturation and tried to use that in my originals afterwards. And this is an example of that process. Over time, my astigmatism increased and I had to start wearing glasses. And once again, I started using less contrast in my work. People wondered if it was the black paper that I was using for quick sketches. But whatever it was, it didn't really concern me and it didn't bother me. I kind of liked how my work was coming out. Now this one is a reworking of the previous painting, and the people stand out more and there's more contrast, lights and darks. And the reason for this is that over the last year and a half, I've had a form of macular degeneration in my left eye. So now, my sense of color and contrast has been reignited. Again, I've started reworking previous pieces, but now without the Photoshop step. The reason is different. As the contrast in my left eye seems to have dulled slightly, I seem to be striving to get the intensity and the color and contrast back so I can see it from a distance. So I finally am kind of agreeing with the others who had been talking about that all along. Now for treatment, I've been going to Mass Eye and Ear, and I look forward to a procedure where they inject my veins with dyes and photograph my right eye. I experience the most exciting, amazing color show, light show, of intense colors and forms that change before my eyes. I could swear that I saw at one point an incredible Matisse-like profile. Following these exams, I make many sketches and drawings and notes so I don't forget the experience. Presently, I'm welcoming my new focus with no preconceived notion as to how it's going to evolve. And then I've been wondering how different art might be if famous artists had been forced to wear glasses constantly. In the book, The World Through Blunted Sight, Patrick Trepper-Roper states that many impressionists, such as Cézanne, was nearsighted and painted without glasses. So I wonder, is it like Thomas Wolfe said in The Painted Word, that art critics started impressionism while the impressionists were merely drawing what they said, what they saw? If you try it, if you're nearsighted, I bet you'll see impressionistic too. And if you, as you've heard, I do have a show presently at the Very Special Art Gallery, which is an organization that promotes art for people with disability. And I'd like to thank you for inviting me and appreciate sharing my story. Thank you.